If you're referencing a piece of work such as a book, film, or research paper, you should use the cite tag. For instance, in this example, it says in the book Multimedia Foundations, the author states, etc., etc. So what we need to do is, because we've referenced a book called Multimedia Foundations, we need to add the cite tag around that. And this is going to allow the browser to style it in a specific way. Or when you get into CSS, you can style it a specific way. And it helps people with screen readers or with accessibility issues to make sure it reads the page properly. So if we look over here, now this book title is italicized because we've added that cite tag. Now, if you also have definitions in your content, then you need to indicate those as well. There are two ways to do this. For instance, in this paragraph, it talks about a bitmap image is one which is made up of pixels, which are small points of color. This is where we have stated the name of the term or the thing we're defining, and we've actually defined it in the paragraph. When this happens, and it's only the first time that it happens, you don't have to put the definition tag around bitmap every time you mention that word. But since this is the first time we've mentioned bitmap, then we need to put the definition tag around that word. This is going to help us to style it again when we get to, and I should actually close that, when we get to CSS. And it also serves another purpose when the definition is not in the paragraph. So if I click over here, notice that bitmap becomes italicized. Again, this is a generic browser style that lets people know this is a word they should pay attention to. And because it's followed immediately by its definition, that's all we have to do for that word. Now, as this keeps talking about bitmap, it says, this differs from a vector image, which is usually a man-made illustration or image such as a logo. Now, that sounds like a definition for a vector, but that's just an example of a vector. It's not the actual definition. So for vector, what we're going to do is we're going to add the definition tag, and we're going to close it around the word we're trying to define. And we're going to add our title attribute, which will allow us to put the definition of the vector word, and as somebody hovers over it in the browser, that definition will come up. So the definition for vector is illustration or image made up of mathematical lines and points. So now if we look over at this side, we can see again, because we've used the definition tag, this is in italics, but we're not seeing the results of that title tooltip. So let's preview this in the browser to really see what that does. So when I preview this in the browser, if I hover over vector, now it brings up that specific definition for vector image. So make sure when you're writing your content and you cite a source for the first time, or you put a specific vocabulary term that you need to define, and you're going to use those words over and over again, and it's important that people understand them, that you define them the first time you mention them, or that you cite the book source the first time you mention it.